What's up guys, Amy here. Just a quick video tutorial on how to make your website or your landing pages responsive across 5 different devices inside of Groovepages. All right guys, I've logged into Groovepages. Now when you're designing your landing pages as well as your sales funnels inside of Groovepages, you're designing it on the desktop view. All of these icons which represent each device is highlighted in pink. If you want to see the design of your landing page on each individual device, you would go and click each one of these. Okay, so that's the laptop, tablet, iPad, and phone device. This allows you to see your design of your landing page or your sales funnel across different screen sizes. So if we go back to the desktop view, that looks pretty good. The same applies with the laptop view, the tablet device view, but this particular screen size looks a bit squash on the side as well as the heading. And the same applies to the mobile view because the opt-in form looks a bit small. In order to modify the design of the tablet device, like this one, we just double click on it and then this will be highlighted. And all these other devices will not be highlighted in pink. This means that you can now format the design specifically for this device and the remaining devices that aren't highlighted won't be affected by the design. So we'll go ahead and click on the heading. I'm currently in the text element. We need to go to the container, then go into spacing. We want to give it some padding on the side so that it doesn't look too close to the screen. That's fine. So that's only 0.5 in terms of padding. Then you'd go down here. We can also make this heading away from the image and give it some spacing. So in order to do that, we want to go back to this container, and this is highlighting this specific container only, going to spacing and adding some margin on the top to pull it down a bit, and adding some padding on the side here. Let's just increase that. And now if you don't like the look of this particular text, you can go and reduce that text size down to 1 or 1.25. It's a personal preference. I don't really mind it, but if you want it to, you can decrease the font size by going to each text element and reducing it to the right size. Okay, so this looks pretty good. If you wanted to increase this opt-in form size, what you need to do is go to Active Campaign and then go to Spacing. And you can see here, I've indicated a margin of 8. So we'll double click on that and just decrease the margin so that it spreads across the screen. And if we scroll back and have a look, everything's formatted nicely. It's not too close to the screen and we can go ahead and press save. Once it's saved, you will see content save green alert pop up. Now let's go and format the mobile device view. Click on this and you can see right off the bat that the heading's quite big. So what I want to do is click on that and you can reduce that down to 2.25 so that it fits nicely within two lines. Do the same thing and just click on the container element. This highlights the whole container. What we would do is go to spacing, give it some margin on the top so that it's not too close to the image, and I can also give it some padding on the side. And we can also reduce the text size by going here and making that 1.125. And the last thing we want to do is make this opt-in form a bit wider. In order to do that, click on this and then go to Active Campaign Component, then head to Spacing, and it's set on 8. So double click on both the left and right hand side, decrease it so that it's spread across. And if you wanted to, you can also modify this text size too so that it fits nicely like that. Let's have a look at it again. It looks pretty good. Click on Save. You should see content save. Let's go back to the devices screen and click on the desktop. Close out of this. That looks good. Same as the laptop view. Tablet view looks good. And the mobile view looks good as well. So once you're happy with the design on each device and screen size, you just go and click publish. Click on that. It says that content save changes usually go live within a few minutes, but may take longer. You can preview your design by clicking on this eye icon. It will open up a new tab. To see your design at different screen sizes, just go to the corner and then drag in your browser. You can see here the design is changing as you move it in. And that's it. I hope you guys found this video useful. Subscribe, hit that bell notification, and see ya.